the Lord has prepared me, I'll just share with that, because I know the Lord has a provision for each one of us here. Each one. Whether it's about finance, whether it's about healing, whether it's about our family relations or anything. But He has a solution for every that His provision. Amen. I want to just share. Can we go to scripture? Psalms 91, 1 and 2.
He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall remain stable and fixed under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God on whom and in Him I trust.
Yes. Amen. Such a wonderful provision God has kept for us. It's not about wealth. Provision is not always about wealth and food. No. It's about His protection. Yes.
Amen.
He is such a good, not only a good God, but He's a good Father. He protects us from all the snares of the enemy. Every time. We have, now in this world, when we walk outside, we see so many things happening around us. Yet, we have a faith that our God who is in heaven is our shelter. And when He shelters us, there is nothing of the evil one can touch us. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord is our refuge and He is my fortress. Yes. We will not lack in anything.
Amen.
Because He is our provider, Jehovah Jireh. He will never let us down.
Amen.
In
Amen.
Any
Amen.
Area of
yes.
life.
Amen.
I'm just so amazed of how God can do such wonderful things for us. Even though we don't deserve, many a times we do not deserve, but yet He is faithful. He is such a loving God that we cannot understand Him fully. He is so vast. He is so vast. He is full of love and compassion. And also, connect to that, I want to take chapters, Psalms chapter 68, 19.
Blessed be the Lord, who daily loads us with benefits, the God of our salvation.
Amen. Amen. You know, when the Lord was preparing me for this message of provision, the first thing the Lord told me, the provision is the provision of salvation.
Amen.
There is nothing else. The Lord first told me, the first thing I ever did was before the creation was He sacrificed His Son. That was the perfect provision for every mankind. There is nothing beyond that. There is nothing greater than that, I would say, provision, that what God gave us. And because of that, today we can boldly stand and say, we have an eternal life in our Lord Jesus Christ. Because there is nothing but the precious sacrifice, what was the provision given to us in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. I just said one more, I'll just read out. Psalms 107 says, give thanks unto the Lord, for He is good, and His mercy endureth forever. Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Because of His mercy, because of His love, we are alive. Because if it was not so, we would have perished long back into the sin. Because if you go to see nowadays around in this world, we'll see so many things happening. There's so many wicked things, wicked people around us. But yet, God is faithful to protect us amidst of these people. Amen. There are bomb blasts taking place. There are earthquakes, famines. Yet, I would like to share a testimony in regarding this. I was hearing to a testimony of a Hindu lady who has come in the Lord. But it's a very powerful testimony she was sharing. She said she used to call out to spirits in her room. And it's saying this particular spirit used to help her. It was like, you know, a spirit of provision for her. When she wanted exam papers, she used to bring it to her, and she used to get score high percentage and all, because she used to bring everything to her. This spirit, one day she told that, I want to stop my father's transfer from this place to another place. That immediately that spirit went and stopped the transfer. The spirit used to do anything, whatever she used to say. And one more thing she shared was, even in many areas regarding her job and everything, in fact, that spirit helped her in such a way that she got a very good job, everything, whatever she used to ask, she used to get it. So she was so much used to that spirit that she had no need to search for any God. Because everything what she wanted, the spirit was giving. You want a good percentage, take it. Then she shared one more very powerful testimony. The thing is that once there was a massive flood, because due to heavy rains, there was massive flood in that area. And every house was drowned except hers. So that lady asked her, how come your house was left out? She said, I called out to that spirit and that spirit told me, I will put a boundary over there. That water will not enter your house. And that spirit put a boundary over there. So my point here is, if these such evil spirits can do what she says, how much more our Heavenly Father will do for us? Because He is the Almighty God. So if the Almighty God comes in picture, we do not have to take small things. We just command in His name. Amen. And when we command in His name, everything has to come to a halt. It is not about my house. When we command, the entire area gets saved. This is how our salvation and the Spirit of God living in us works. Yes, we are not here to think about one house and one house. We are here about to think about the entire nation. God is working for entire nation. So what I'm trying to say is, God is not a small God who just does small things. Yes, of course, that spirit was doing some things because it had a purpose to destroy our life. But our God is not a destroyer. When He gives freely and abundantly without any measure and without any condition. Because our God is not a God of condition. When He does it truthfully and in righteousness. This lady was telling that whatever the demons were making her do, were doing for her, but they had a purpose. They were making her do it in a wrong way. Because everything what they will do has nothing to do with righteousness. But when our God does it, it is based on righteousness and truth. Because He is a God of truth and His foundation is never shaken. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Also, I'll read out Philippians. Again, Philippians chapter 4:19 clearly says, and my God will meet all my needs according to His riches in Christ Jesus. Yes, amen. In Christ, every provision has been made. Healing, His body, as Sister Yulek said, what the pain, what the flesh was torn. Why? Because the provision was made for our healing, so that we will be free from all sicknesses. Everything was put on Him. Finances. Every finance we are going through. Yes, it's true that we face through many things. But yet, we have that promise. We have the promise that one day we will be successful because it's the promise of God. It's not our words, but it's God's word that keeps us going. That we will not fail, nor we will lack in anything because God is our shield and our strength.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Psalms 126:6, chapter 126, verse 6 says, man says, show me and I will trust you. But God says, trust me and I will show you.
Amen.
This is man's ways. Show me, then I will. I remember when I was in London, I was sharing about God's message to about what He has done in my life to one lady. She's a Britisher working over there. And she's telling me, unless I see, how should I believe you? So the scripture says, it is not about our belief. When we put our trust, man's trust is in seeing. But God's trust is in putting trust in Him.
Amen.
When we put trust in God's word, we will see things come to pass. Because that's our faith. That's how faith works.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Even Matthew 6:33. Before provision, are we sure that our lives are prepared? Are our lives according to the will of God? Are we going and walking through the will of God? We have to see, are we in line with the word of God? Are our lives pleasing to Him? If not, The word of God says, but seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all the things shall be provided for you. Amen. Here is the clear explanation that when our lives are pleasing to God, the provisions are already being made in the heavenly realm. Yes, that's how God works. We have to search from our heart. Our hearts have to be knit together with oneness with God. That's how God's kingdom is working. When we are attached to his kingdom, nothing of the things in our this world we will lack in anything, because that's how provision is being done, given for all mankind. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I just thank God, because it's a wonderful thing the Lord is using each one of us with every day. It's a new message, it's a new encouragement God gives, because everyone here has a purpose in life, and our purpose, we stand here and speak for God, it is fulfilled in Christ Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
One more, the Lord was telling me a few days back, I was very worried. In fact, I'll tell you, there was it's a real testimony. One morning when I got up suddenly from sleep, because I felt in spirit as kind of a spirit of suicide standing next to me. And suddenly the Lord woke me up, and I'm thinking, I felt a strong presence of some spirit next to my bed. And then I asked the Lord, what was here that was staring? The Lord told me that spirit was staring at you continuously. And I asked the Lord, what kind of spirit was that? The Lord told me that spirit of suicide was staring at you like anything. And I remember, in all this commotion and things happening around me, every time that spirit should come and tell me, oh, your family is not bothered now, so you better give up. It's all over. The Lord is also not bothered about you. Nothing is happening, so it's time you free yourself. And I should say, no way. I said that God has paid my price. My life is no more of me.
Yes,
it belongs to Jesus.
Yes, amen.
If I commit my life into your hands, I know what you're going to do with me. I'd rather commit myself to
amen,
God.
Amen.
So if I have to go through, even I have to fall in trouble, it's for his glory. He is there, he will lift me up. And that's the time I had seen that vision, that when I fall, the Lord lifted me up, because he was so, so loving. His love was so much for me. It touched my heart. And I told the Lord that time, never will I ever even entertain that spirit of thought of suicide in my life anymore. Because from now on, my life is only and only for you. It's dedicated for you till I see you in your
amen,
heavenly realms.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Because the Lord gave me the scripture, as Matthew 6:26 says, look at the birds, they don't plant or harvest or store or feed in the barns, for your heavenly Father feeds them. And aren't you far more valuable to him than they are? Amen. So the Lord said, if I can feed these birds who are there, who are of no value compared to you, why will I not do it for you? Why will I not save you? Why will I not reach out to you? Amen.
Amen.
I was so touched. I was so thrilled. Why should I waste this life, this precious life, what God has given me? God is my provider. But what am I giving back to him? If I can give him best, what I could give him is my life. If I can glorify him, it's through my life. If I can do anything for him, for what he has done for me, is give up my life for his sake. That's the best I can do. I can do nothing beyond that, but that is glorify his name by my life. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Before I wind up, I just want to say one more thing, that God has a provision for everyone here, whether it's small thing. Last night when I was preparing this message of provision, the Lord was showing me is the provisions of healing. As I was praying for everyone, for Auntie Gracie, I was praying for the land, I was praying for our relation, our finances, and all the people over here. So the Lord was showing me faces. And as I was preparing, the Lord was putting in my heart, even before we ask, He knows everything and he has done it. For him, it's done. The chapter is closed. It is we who have to step forward,
amen,
claim it by faith,
yes,
and receive,
amen,
it. Whether it's healing, finance, land, clearing of the land, everything. It's spoken already. It's spoken and it's done in his court. It's granted.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.